this line with the only goal on Friday night. Luke Martin sends it across. There's Quinn Hughes back in the Michigan lineup after playing for Team USA at the World Junior Championship. The freshman that gets so much attention. Dexter Danks in deep, leaned on by Wade. Justin Wade playing in his 100th game as a member of the Fighting Irish.
Keep an eye on Quinn Hughes. He's an undersized defenseman. With today's NHL, you need that puck-moving defenseman. He's a top prospect for this upcoming NHL draft.
And back in comes O'Leary. O'Leary can't barge through, and he'll head back to the bench on a change. It'll be kept in by Dennis Gilbert. Good hustle by Gilbert in the slot. And a huge stop there by Hayden Levine. Cal Burke a chance, and now back to Evans. He'll spin it to Gilbert. Winding, firing, rebound. Burke, a backhand, and it's stopped by Levine. And the puck cleared past Gilbert. C-line. Pass for Danks into the skates of Calderon. Couldn't find it, and now Morrison back. Lead feed Tyson. Stepped over the line offside.
Let's go back and take a look at the Dennis Gilbert chance here. This Irish D are very active. They're not afraid to jump into the offensive zone and get pucks to the net and jump in.
See group of Mel Pearson. Puck is fired in and first one to it, Cal Burke. Cam Morrison tied up. Morrison, another one of the forwards that Jeff Jackson's looking for a little more production out of after 12 goals in a freshman year. He is sitting on 4 so far.
There's so much upside to him. He had a tremendous season in the USHL and then now going to Notre Dame. He had a bit of a slow start as a freshman. He's still very young, but he's got that big body he's still trying to grow into.
Here's Quinn Hughes deep in the zone. Hughes with a dish back to Luke Martin, and now it's centered. Calderon couldn't get it through. And Dennis Gilbert is up with it. Gilbert trying to leg it out for the Irish, and he gets to the red line and now gets upended of late, giving up 8 in the last 14 shorthanded situations. Helix it across, and Cal Burke fanned on that. Didn't get good wood on it and missed an open net. Nardella moves in. Side of the net it goes for Morrison. Morrison looks to center. Burke trying to get it back. Now stepping up is Helixson. And Quinn Hughes checked by Morrison. Finally, it's Luke Martin up with it. And they'll work it ahead for Calderon, who has been evicted from the penalty box. Approaching the midway mark of this opening period, an edge in play for Notre Dame, but it remains scoreless. Quinn Hughes through center, slickly over the line. He lost his balance, and it's a quick counter here. Back the other way comes Jenkins. Jack Jenkins over the line. Justin Wade fires it right on. Kicked it into the corner. Up the boards it goes for Perikos and out to Pastiaw.
Go to Michigan. If that was the case, I'd have put in a phone call.
You know, Mel Pearson told us the other day that he tried to recruit Cooper Maroney to Michigan Tech. He's glad he lost that recruiting battle.
It's paying big dividends now.
Percent deficiency. Maroney, Calderon, Danks with Hughes and Ciccone on the points. And out to the penalty killing role, Dawson Cook will start along with Jake Evans. Here comes Ciccone. Dropping it for Hughes, and Hughes will weave his way in. The freshman blue liner back to Ciccone. Now on the wall for Maroney. 22 assists on the year. Calderon's the shooter. Hughes will fire, and he missed the target. Been over 7 minutes since the last shot on goal for Michigan. Maroney sets it up again. Fans on the pass. Surrounded, but centers. Loose Hughes in front. And Morris got a stick on that with Danks on the doorstep. Here's Hughes again. Cross ice, and that pass shot whipped wide off the stick of Calderon. Boy, Hughes has great vision, doesn't he?
He really does. He's got like a little Phil Housley in him. Buffalo Sabres head coach, was an offensive defenseman in National Hockey for a long time. What Quinn Hughes doesn't have for size, he makes up for hockey IQ and also offensive ability.
On the doorstep. Best chance for Michigan. And now it's Winborg. Raby trying to put on more pressure. Wegworth up with it. And around to the far side. Evans wins his fifth consecutive draw, but it comes back to Ciccone. And across for Hughes. Cal Burke on Hughes, but he got away. Moving in deep. centers in front. Cale Morris there. What another slick play by Quinn Hughes. As Mel Pearson, the coach, said, every player on the ice has to be ready at all times because you never know when or where Hughes is going to dispatch the puck. Now Evans, Morrison in the corner, flicks to the far side for Burke, tries to center, and Levine knocks it down and holds on.
Let's go back and take a look at this escape here by Quinn Hughes. I mean, this is the freshman defenseman. Not only is it the talent to make that play, but he has the confidence to even try it. I mean, pushing the puck into empty space, able to use his quickness to beat Notre Dame forward up front to get that loose puck. He's able to create something out of nothing from the blue line. Impressive play by the Michigan Wolverines young freshman defenseman.
Youngest player in NCAA hockey, 18 years of age, 3 assists at the World Junior Championship, was in touch with head coach Mel Pearson every day while away and was anxious to get back. Quinn Hughes starts out. Here's Hughes weaving through center, but Evans there to check him. Quick turnover here and a counter here for Cal Burke. And Burke gets knocked off the puck. Morrison overskates it. And it's Sanchez to an open wing. Quinn Hughes trying to catch up to it. And Andrew Peak, his World Junior teammate, got there first. It'll come back to Quinn Hughes. Now Norris setting it up. Slaker behind the net, trying the jam play, and on it is Morris as Michigan goes to the attack. Back to Hughes at the line. Watched by Tyson. Jordan Gross cuts off the pass and now flipped through center. Off the glove of Ogilvy. Warren's got it back for Michigan. Over the line is Slaker with room, and Cale Morris holds on to that. Here comes O'Leary over the line. Puck fired in by Dawson Cook. O'Leary after the rebound. And Quinn Hughes up on the left side. Perikos unable to hit Pastiov with that pass. Back into the Michigan zone. Jack Jenkins along with Cook. But worked ahead by Luke Martin, the St. Louis native. Pastiov over the line. Hughes jumped up and just couldn't take the pass cleanly. Hughes takes a lap on the backhand, holds on. Quinn Hughes circles around, surveys, still looking for something, and it gets past Pastiov. They were changing. Boca trying to hustle across there, and Jenkins at the end of a shift in his sophomore season. So Notre Dame gets one that stays on the board, and they have the lead here at the 6:10 mark of the second period. And coming back in, that shot sails high. Malmquist lost his footing, but the puck off the ledge comes back down around his territory. Martin battling there, and Quinn Hughes will take charge. His pass nearly got stolen by Ogilvy. Up ahead for Marody. The DMC line back to work, looking for a response. It's a pass from Danks back to Hughes. And across, Luke Martin shooting. Rebound! Oh, what a stop there! Huge stop by Cale Morris on the doorstep as Michigan comes close. Quinn Hughes sidestepped Brower in deep. Unable to center it the first time. Has another chance. Puts it in the goal mouth, and Cale Morris smothers that. Is spit back out into the slot, and Wade is able to clear. Well, it's kept in at the line. Danks momentarily. Now Evans trying to get loose. He's checked by Danks. Back in comes Cooper Marody. Marody with almost a point a game in his collegiate career. And down goes Morrison.
Big hit there by Dexter Danks. On that line, he's the physical grinder. He's the guy that goes up and down, creates room for the other two wingers. And he showed you his physicality there on that big hit.
6'2", 205. Dexter Danks, a senior. Quinn Hughes to the attack. Hughes along the boards. Marody comes up with it. He's surrounded, but the puck stays on his stick. And still in the zone as Danks holds it in. Desperate guy on the ice, huh? Boca made the play, and now 40 seconds left in the power play. It's Ciccone looking for the trailer, and that was taken away. Good positioning there by Jack Jenkins. So Quinn Hughes will try it. Will spin around at center, and that second move doesn't work, and Jenkins will clear.
I like the offensive upside by Quinn Hughes. Sometimes he's got to reel it back in a little bit. It's a little bit too high risk, for my liking sometimes, but you have to love the courage and the ability for the young defenseman to try to make those moves. Just pick his spots a little better.
He's not shy.
He's not. Definitely not. I think that'll come with age. As he becomes more mature as a hockey player, he becomes older and with more experience, he'll know when to try those moves and when not to.
Brody rink wide, finds Hughes, the penalized player, back on the ice. Hughes trying to spin it in front. Brower is there, and out come the Irish, three abreast. It's O'Leary dragged down, and now we'll get a penalty the other way. Calderon will get the gate.
Luckily for them, they're able to keep the puck in the offensive zone.
And so I was a little surprised Michigan just sent the puck down the ice there. They might have been able to attack a defenseman without a stick, but just cleared the zone. And
the Wolverines had a nice, strong push, but they're just not as deep as they would like to be. And it showed in the scoring chances, not having the finish to finish off those nice plays.
Shots on goal, 23-21 for the Wolverines, but down by two here in the second period. There's Morrison, unable to reach that. Quinn Hughes heads back for the Wolverines. Dexter Dakes on the right wing. Stops up, lost it. Morrison can't get loose. Gilbert ahead. And now Morrison after it against Luke Martin. Stick knocked out of the hands of Morrison. Another penalty pending. And out of the net goes Morris for the extra attacker. Comes across for Dennis Gilbert. Shooting, and he wires that high. Kept in at the line by Tyson. Tyson shoots it high. Back down for Gilbert. Across, great pass, and a glove stop by Levine. That team that won 15 straight and were undefeated in 28 back in 91. And here we go in 2017, or 2018. I better turn the calendar, Anson. Try to win their 15th consecutive again.
Tell you what, nobody wanted to go up to Lake State, Sault Ste. Marie, Michigan, and play against those Coach Jackson teams. They're tough teams to play against. They had some skill, but they're stingy in the defensive front at all times.
Cam Morrison scoops it across. I think it's fair to say that what the coach told us this morning, here's a chance first. Ogilvie and Hayden Levine, the stop with the rebound. Bounce there on Tyson. It's Ogilvie again trying to center it. Good start for Notre Dame.
Blowing a wheel there, losing his edge. I'm sure he's going to train him to take a look at that. But if you don't have the solid entries, it makes it tough for the rest of your power play to set up and get any momentum going.
So the DMC line comes out, and Quinn Hughes goes to work. And that shot deflects up onto the netting. Out of play.
Quinn Hughes is such a silky smooth skater there, CC. I mean, he's effortlessly just glides to the neutral zone. And well, this rush here, Quinn Hughes is able to transfer the puck all by himself. Like, this is a big weapon to have for a power play, to have a smooth skating defenseman that could see the ice that well, but also has the ability to skate the puck into the offensive zone to set up the power play.
One goal on the year for Quinn Hughes. It came in his college debut. This is the guy they want with the puck. Although he'll back it off to Marody. It's not a bad option either, is it?
Not at all.
Here's Cooper Marody, and he'll swing around, take a look. And now hand it to Ciccone. Calderon, who's the finisher usually on the power play. Marody once again. There's Calderon. Swept it across. Hughes. Watched by Burke. Under a half minute to go. Ciccone's shot. That is blocked. And it'll be Jenkins starting back, shorthanded. He's got Burke going to the net, and Hayden Levine holds on to that shorthanded chance.
Well, even with a guy like Jake Evans, one of the top scorers in the country, I mean, he's not a flashy, dynamic offensive player like we've seen times in the Vols. And just having the mountains, the background, and this the party atmosphere, I mean, 3,000, 4,000, 5,000 people in the arena, and everyone's singing and dancing, it's great.
Stretch pass there for Calderon, deep in Notre Dame territory. Back to the point, there's Quinn Hughes moving in. Hughes to the attack, and he can't pull the trigger. Broken up by Dennis Gilbert. In behind Marody. Dexter Dinks, tracked by Gilbert. Back for Hughes and across. Ciccone into the slot. Calderon well covered there as Evans comes up high defensively. Calderon whips that high and over the net. Been an extended period of time between shots on goal for Michigan. Now back comes the captain. Here's Evans dropping it off. Gross across, one-timer, big stop. Hayden Levine, oh, he read that play beautifully and makes the save off Tyson.
What a save. That's when it comes in handy, being 6'3", using that long reach of that left pad to shoot it out to make the save.
Well, see if that gives the Michigan bench a boost, because he had to go post to post, and Tyson got all of it. Now it is Malmquist in, tries to center it, and that's intercepted, and Pasty offs it down into the Notre Dame zone. Andrew Peak quickly ahead. Terrific pass to Tyson, looking for Morrison. That doesn't work, and turning back is Slaker. Here's Jake Slaker over the line, and he is checked. Good play by Gilbert, held in, though, by Hughes. Quinn Hughes walks in, and they score! Norris on the rebound after Morris had made the initial stop, and the lead has been cut in half.
A little too sloppy with the puck. And there's Quinn Hughes, always dangerous, jumping in off the blue line, making things happen. Not selling for being back on his heels. He's on his toes. Young freshman defenseman going to the net. And then you see Josh Morris just hanging around, putting home that puck. He's definitely a first rounder. We've seen a lot of good high-end young players. Charlie McAvoy, Noah Hannafin. And also you could add Quinn Hughes to that list as well, too. Players that could probably go in the top 10 in the National Hockey League draft.
Yeah, high-end first rounder for sure, with all the attention he is getting.
You know, puck coming across the slot to Levine, making that left pad save to keep it 2-0, keeping his team in the hockey game, giving them a chance.
Now the DMC line out, trying to follow up that goal-scoring shift. But out come the Irish, and it's Malmquist on the left side, and the Edina High School star will send it down into Michigan ice. So approaching the midway mark of this third period, shots are 29-25 in favor of Notre Dame, but the lead now just one. Boy, Cale Morris made another terrific stop prior to that goal going in as he robbed Hughes, but had no chance on the rebound. Cook is in. Jenkins trying to get it back to him, and unable to reach that. Nardella. Quinn Hughes for Michigan. Up it goes to Dakota Raby. Here comes Joe Wigworth into the zone. Drops it off, and a fan there on a chance for Brower. Brower, Wigworth, and Jenkins out together. And it's Brower hit by Boca along the end boards. Wigworth up with a puck. Back to the point and across for Nardella. And Nardella's shot ricochets off Pastiov and back into the Notre Dame zone. That's cut off by Nardella, and he quickly leads the attack back. Good counter here by Nardella. Throws it in front. Loose puck. Berkus, second whack at it, and it's gloved away. Michael Pastiov on the back post. Maybe saved the goal. Cal Burke with a couple of great chances there to restore the two-goal lead.
Great back check there by Michael Pastiov, coming down low, helping his defenseman out, collapsing, and making sure he outmans the Irish coming into his net.
Just the sixth game in the lineup for the freshman Pastiov. Now Ciccone and Quinn Hughes get things organized. The Irish start to change. And here comes Ciccone. Danks was tied up by Gilbert. Danks stretches out, got a stick on it, but Marody has to come back to recalculate at center. Now it's Piazza dumping it in. Here comes Slaker, as you can sense some momentum building for Michigan. But now out comes Notre Dame. Malmquist on the left side, trying to beat Ciccone to the outside. He'll swing deep, looking to center. And Norris intercepts and starts back for Michigan. With a pass over the line, Norris follows up. Here's Ciccone in. Big stop and the rebound cleared by Wade. That's a key save for Cale Morris.
He was able to clear that puck out of the net, baseball style. Great hand-eye coordination there from the senior defenseman.
Marody back on the ice, back to the attack. Wade tied up. Marody picked his pocket for his 17th win of the year. Faceoff won by the Wolverines. Comes back to Ciccone. His shot, and that hit a skeet in front as Gross tied up Sanchez. Back to Ciccone again to reload and fire. Glove stop, poised at the point along with Hughes, but Notre Dame controls and flip it out. Hayden Levine still in the net, and we're down to 100 seconds remaining here in regulation time. Hughes gave it up. Ogilvy steals and a quick shot that Levine got a glove on.
So that's what I was talking about earlier. You got to know when you got to pick your spots there. And he's still a freshman, but he'll learn eventually.
Down the ice, a sharp angle shot by Slaker held on.
But here's Quinn Hughes again, trying to dangle Andrew Ogilvy in his own zone. I mean, I appreciate young defenseman's confidence, but there's a time and a place you got to make those plays, and you don't want to do that in your own zone. You want to try to be creative in the offensive zone and not so much the defensive zone.
There's a face-off win for Michigan. Hughes across. There's Slaker shot. Gilbert blocked. Marodi a whack at it.
It was a little premature and blowing the whistle. So Quinn Hughes trying to show shot. He's able to get Cal Burke to bite. He dishes it down low. Jake Slaker tries to get the puck on net.
Plays it back to the point off that face-off win by Marodi. Down went Norris. He's the extra man out there. And lost his footing, an empty net here for Evans, and Ciccone gets back in time. So down to the final minute as Notre Dame tries to hold on, and Michigan pushes for the equalizer. It's Marodi to the line, but he can't barge through. Broken up by Cal Burke. Marodi tied up again at the blue line, and they'll have to regroup. It'll be Quinn Hughes to the controls. Hughes gets over the red line and sends it in. Slaker goes after it. Gilbert along the boards. Moves it a little further, and Burke gets it out. Good play by Burke, and now Gilbert flipping it to the red line. Ciccone across for Hughes. One move, and he's in on the right side, and that shot by Slaker, rebound! And where is it in front? A chance there for Calderon. So they get a couple of looks, and now down to 10 seconds left. Gilbert trying to keep it in the corner. The big defenseman killing time. It's running out on Michigan. And it's going to be a 15-game win streak for the Notre Dame Fighting Irish.
The 1-1 tie yesterday. Again, the additional point going to the Wolverines with a shootout win. Calderon drops it off. Harris for Hughes behind the net. Now back out to the blue line. Ciccone. Marodi, side of the net. That one tipped away. Leffman got a stick on it, redirected. This top line for Michigan State, the KHL line, Hiroshi Kotarenko and Lewandowski has accounted for more than 40% of the points. This is a Michigan State team that has struggled to score at times this year. Michigan by far the better offensive team so far.
But shot on net, he wasn't too happy about that, so they need improvement in that area.
Brody Stevens, this is the fourth line for the Wolverines. He's in the near corner, he lost it, but now a turnover. Opportunity here for the Spartans, that shot wide by Austin Kamer. Spartans keep it in. Right down below us, Osborne to the near corner. Battling in the near corner, Spartans keep it in. Dump it behind the Wolverines net, and Michigan State will change lines. That's Quinn Hughes. He's an exciting player to keep an eye on. One of the young defensemen for the Wolverines, simply one of the best players in college hockey right now. Yeah, that shot redirected.
If I wasn't in this spot, Dan, I'd pay money to see him play. He's that good. He's got that it factor you look for.
And when Fred Pletch says that, pay attention. Or had the puck taken away. Back come the Wolverines, 3-on-3.
Penalty coming up to Michigan State.
6-on-5 right now. Hughes to Ciccone. Marodi lost an edge, got back up, controlled the puck. Man advantage on the delay call. That shot went wide. Hughes will gather it in for the Wolverines, send it back to the blue line, and now the Spartans will touch.
For third place now, 33 points, third all by himself.
Centering pass, Spartans stopped it with a skate, almost an opportunity for the Wolverines. They were 0-for-2 on the power play last night in East Lansing. Spartans only had one power play opportunity. It was a major, but they only had one shot in 5 minutes. Special teams have been struggles at times for both these teams. That shot, save, or did it not get through? I don't think it got through.
No, blocked. Tommy Miller leads the team with now 65. He's a rubber-eating machine, Dan.
Hughes, Ciccone, Danks, Calderon, Marodi on the ice right now for the Wolverines. Spartans quickly swap out their forwards. They've got Saliba up front right now with Hirose. Hughes carries it in. He's an offensive force. He's a defenseman, but he's an offensive force. They just rave about his creativity and vision. Ciccone, far side Marodi. 4 goals in 2 games against the Spartans in this arena. Hughes will circle back. Far side Marodi. Slot left side. Shot. Blocker save. Right shoulder for Letheman, and the Spartans clear the zone. Even though the numbers may not look terrific for either team on special teams, Fred, I know both coaches
know to keep their head up when 44 is on the ice.
Luke Martin circling behind his own net. Hughes will pick it up. Carried out far side, but ridden off the puck. Spartans keep it in, but Hughes will just grab it and head out center ice. Now circle back. Far right side. Puck shot in by Jack Becker. That's the fourth line for the Wolverines. That shot did not get through. It's loose.
When I talked to Danton Cole before the game, he said he just has to get up to game speed. He'll be okay. Chris Luongo coaches the D.
Lambden's shot went off of Levine out front, but the Wolverines grab it. That shot got through Miller from the point, but an easy save for Levine. And again, you'll see this more often than not in this matchup. I love the creation of the Iron D. A lot of work went into that, and it's just, I think it's a fun thing for both these teams to be able to play here, either at Joe Louis last couple of years or Little Caesars Arena.
Some heft and strength to you.
Slaker wins a draw against Saliba. Hughes has it, carries in, shot, pad save. Skate right at the tip of the skate. Pad save for Letheman. Wolverines held it in? No, they did not. After the draw, that puck goes all the way back behind the Michigan goal. Lewandowski knocked off the puck by Ciccone, and the Wolverines clear. That'll be, nope, it's going to go on net. Martins flip it out and into the Michigan zone, and that will be an icing call. Faceoff back down into the Spartans' end. Talk about young guys. We're just looking forward to watching this guy play tonight. Quinn Hughes, youngest player in college hockey.
Well, just tremendous bloodlines. His father was former director of player development for the Toronto Maple Leafs. His mom was an outstanding hockey player in her own right, world silver medalist at the 1992 World Women's Championships. So he's got hockey from both sides of his parentage. Because, you know, Hirose and Kotarenko are excellent penalty killers, so it becomes an issue, especially on the second end of back-to-backs, although last night Michigan State just had to kill two.
Hughes tried to get it to Marodi. Instead, it went to Calderon. Centering pass, and it's deflected, not controlled by Letham, and an opportunity for the Wolverines. And the Spartans relieve the pressure. Ooh, a little misplay by Letham, and he left it right in front of the net. Now Hughes carrying back in for the Wolverines. Near side corner, ridden off the puck. Apak behind his own net. Lost control of it. Marodi knocks it away. He's got the Wolverines' goal, and that's why they lead 1-0 with 2.5 to go here in the first period. Hughes, great vision. Gets it down low for Danks. Shot didn't get through. Wolverines back it up. 25 seconds left in the power play. Marodi circling far corner. Gets it. Tried to get it back to Hughes, but angled it off the boards poorly. And to start the second period, Wolverine's penalty kill again does not grade out very well. Mel Pearson feels like it's more feel thing. He says, I just feel like the feel on the power play, even though we may be giving up some goals, he just sees more consistency over the 2 minutes, sometimes late goal, at times a high scoring unit. Spartans did have a 6-goal effort last weekend against the fifth-ranked Ohio State Buckeyes. That puck goes high and off the screens.
The opposition, which Michigan does, usually you're going to be successful more often than not.
And on the flip side, Michigan State has now been outshot in 13 of their last 14 games. In front of the net, Spartans try to jam it in. Never did get a shot on Levine. The Spartans keep it in. Wolverines take it away, wrap it around the boards near side.
Although we should point out, everyone's fond of saying when these teams face off, throw the stats out the window. This is will and emotion over skill.
The one thing you will say, if the Wolverines build on their 1-0 lead, it does become very difficult. It is something that is of concern for the Spartans, even though they've been scoring more, generating more scoring chances. It's tough for this team to come from behind.
Yeah, they don't want to chase the game too much.
Gat Miller, too far for Hirose. Hughes will circle, get it to Becker. Carrying out center ice, he'll flip it in. Pass to Chaser. Osborne will battle him in the corner. Oh, it's turnover there. Gafari put it right on the stick. Porikos did not get it on net. Back to the blue line, Hughes. Scored last night, second goal of the year. That shot off a skate. That shot didn't get through. Big opportunity, though, for the Wolverines again, Porikos.
And this is a line that was on the ice when Hughes scored last night. Pastiav and Perico's assisting.
Ciccone to Hughes. Mel Pearson couldn't say enough good things about Quinn Hughes. We talked about him earlier, but it's the creativity that stands out. That shot goes high and wide over the right shoulder of Lethemann.
And his edge work is just unbelievable. Work for the CCHA for over a dozen years. I witnessed firsthand the ongoing dedication that Mike Ilitch and the whole family had to college hockey and what they have done and continue to do for the college hockey player. If there's a college hockey Hall of Fame, he's a first ballot member for certain. Of course, he's a member of the Hockey Hall of Fame for his stewardship of the Red Wings.
Hard to remember when he took over the Red Wings how low they were. And he brought them back to the greatness they had experienced for decades before. 1-0 game here. An early goal from Cooper Marody with an assist from Tony Calderon. Podorenko carries in 1-on-4. His shot handcuffs as they're standing by. One minute left on the power play for the Wolverines. They've got the 1-0 lead. And slot on the right side of Lethemann. Now the pass and a shot by Hughes. One timer and a save by Lethemann. Osborne, oh, he tried to wrap it around the board. Got a bad bounce.
You want to know why there's 20 or 30 NHL scouts here to watch Quinn Hughes. Watch this pass out of the corner. He's not even looking at Cooper Marody. And he saucer passes it with authority, gets it back, and gets a shot on goal. That is a ton of skill right there.
What's the thing that stands out the most about Quinn Hughes to you, Fred?
Well, it's the way he skates, for sure. It's his head for the game and his escapability. He's a one-man zone entry, and he plays with his head up all the time. He sees everything on the ice. He knows where everyone else is and what they're doing.
30 seconds left on the power play. Shorthanded, Spartans come in.
Yeah, you want to talk escapability. Watch Quinn Hughes' goal last night. This is Houdini-like. Pass job to Perikos, and here's Quinn Hughes.
Wow.
Was in a sandwich between two Spartans, and John Lethemann couldn't get a read on him either. All of a sudden, it's on the back end and into the yawning cage, as they say.
Talk that he could be a top five pick next year in this year's draft, Fred. What do you think? One more year, or do you think he's gone after 1 year?
If Zach Werenski stayed two seasons at Michigan, I think it would behoove Quinn Hughes to stay two as well. You know, Dan Cole had a good observation, and it wasn't about Quinn Hughes. It was about one of his own players. He said, there's no position called offenseman in hockey. You have to learn to play D, and Quinn Hughes with the marvelous offensive talent. If they can lean on him to improve his defensive game, I think it'd be great for him.
Michigan State for the rest of the night. Ciccone carries in. He's on the blue line now with Hughes, top line, Marody, Warren, and Calderon. Although I see now it's they flip-flop guys on the left wing, and Dexter Danks is in there right now on the left wing for that top line, Marody, Calderon, other Constants. Sanford killing some time. 4.5 still to kill. Wolverines will carry out. Dexter Danks. Marody. Ridden off the puck by Rosberg. No, he maintained control. Got it back to Ciccone. In the slot, good passing by the Wolverines, but good defense preventing Dexter Danks from getting a shot off on the doorstep. Hughes. Marody. Went to Ciccone behind him, but Ciccone keeps it in, dumps it to the corner to Danks. Tried to center it. Osborne has it, and he'll flip it out.
and Michigan State has killed so far. 1 minute and 20 seconds of this 5 minute major. Hughes with a 360 spin works it out of his own zone for Norris, carrying it in on the far side.
Mel Pearson says a couple times a week in practice, Hughes will do something like that, and most of his players will look at him with the "Did you just see that?" look on their face.
Out there, along with Hughes and Ciccone, this is how this 5 minute major started for Michigan. That one got by Hughes. So far, the Spartans done an excellent job, but they still have work to do. A minute 40 left in this 5 minute major. 1-0 Wolverines, 3 minutes to go, second period. Now Marody comes in, blocker save by Lethemann. Fine job, a scoring opportunity for a guy who has 4 goals in 2 games against Michigan State in this arena. Ciccone has it. He'll flip it on net. So far, only a couple of shots on net in this 5 minute major for Michigan. Marody, harassed by Miller, will carry it toward the side of the net. His shot was deflected behind. Danks has it. Lost it. Gafari lost it. Wolverines control. Danks slot left side, shot wide.
Yeah, you'd think Michigan's power play would have much better numbers, especially with two guys, Marody and Hughes, who can control the puck for extended lengths of time inside the zone.
You wouldn't expect them to be bottom five in college hockey, but that's where they are. Two of the youngest teams in Division I college hockey. 30 seconds left. One last rush for the Spartans. Instead, the Wolverines take it away. Spartans have not been able to create a ton of pressure, not a lot of big scoring opportunities tonight. Wolverines ended up with 9 shots during that 5 minute major. Last 10 seconds of the second period. Spartans trying to dig it out of the far corner. Estevez. Wolverines, though, take it away from him. Final seconds, and the second period will come to an end. Since January the 2nd, when he scored his first goal in the GLI.
Cooper playing for summer bragging rights against his former Orchard Lake St. Mary teammate, Cody Milan. They always get together. And they don't text during the week. They keep it civil, but if they cross paths after the game, they might stop and say hello. But
spot of Lewandowski, so it's 19 instead of 9 on the line with Kotarenko and Hirose. Hirose off the faceoff shot, score! Fifth and final meeting of the year between these two teams. Carrying it in is Sanford, and that shot deflected off the net, face-off stage in the Michigan zone. Far side, it's the Danks Laker Norris line for the Wolverines. Hirose, Kiefer, Kotarenko for the Spartans. Lewandowski with a 5 minute major is done for the night. Spartans try to keep it in, cannot. Right down below us, Miller ahead to Stevens. Wolverines take control. Hughes circles behind his own net. 2-1 Wolverines, 5 minutes into the third period. The duel for the D, the Iron D at stake. Martin will carry in. That's Cutler Martin. Gatt, pass out in front, goes right to Hughes. Hughes looking, has that great vision, circling. Gets it back to the line. Ciccone shot. Oh, blocked, and that hurts. Stevens cannot get up. He's going to have a hard time just getting to his own bench. Stevens comes off. Wolverines carry back in. That shot just wide by Hughes. Martin behind the Spartans' goal. The Spartans had the early goal in this period, but the offensive play carried mostly by the Wolverines through 6 minutes of play. Gatt will carry out as he relieves some pressure. Flipping it in is Tommy Apap. Ryan will settle it down for Hughes. Hughes' long pass for Dexter Danks, tied up by Osborne. Wasper's member also took a shot off the toe, but he's back on the ice. As Fred said, just give me some ice. Ice time. Marody carries it in. Shot trickles through. Danks will control. Ciccone. Now the Spartans will break out. Sanford has help on the right side with Tommy Apap, but he'll dump in. Apap will come off. Quick change of the forwards for Michigan State.
Tony Calderon showing a 200-foot game there. He came back and nullified the two-on-one. It was a two-on-two in a hurry.
Hughes will carry in for Michigan. The defenseman with offensive skills carries it in, maintains control. Dexter Danks, Ciccone, and Ciccone will just dump it in for Calderon. He'll let it go for Marody. Top of the circle, gets it down low. Calderon, his shot had no angle at all. Morosi has it, but he's flattened by Ciccone. Gatt to Miller. Miller's shot penalty coming up on the Wolverines.
And I think it could be five.
Kodorenko. Spartans control. They've got a man advantage for the moment on the delay call. That shot got through from Miller. Kiefer to Kodorenko. Centering pass. Wolverines control. Landon carries in. Thanks comes out of the penalty box. Ciccone, who maybe should have been in there, wraps it on the far side boards. Down below us, Danks turns it over. He gets it ahead, I should say, to Calderon. Marody carries in. Far side now. Ciccone. Hughes, shot, score! Great passing by the Wolverines. Third of the year for Hughes.
Watch Cooper Marody. He's not carrying the puck. Instead of going to the net, he floats in behind Calderon, draws Osborne to him, gets it across, and by that time, the late man, Quinn Hughes, had arrived on the scene in behind Marody and Osborne. Osborne was watching Marody. Nobody on Quinn Hughes. And the outstanding freshman with his second in as many nights against the Wolverines, arch rivals.
That shot score! David Kiefer with his third of the year. The Spartans back to within one.
Kiefer with a legit snipe over the glove of Hayden Levine, and it's a one-goal game again. Lots of fun here.
Danton Cole talks a lot about his team playing with pace, and he feels like David Kiefer is one of those guys who's playing with great pace lately. And like you said, waited for the opportunity and sniped it. One-goal game with 4 minutes to go. Rosberg tied up in the near corner down to our left. Marody, Osborne battling as well. Danks got it. His shot was blocked.
Let's go!
Marody, Landon took it away. Flips it far side boards. Estevez gets it to Landon. He's knocked to the ice. Collision at center ice between Osborne and Calderon. That shot got through. Rebound! Saved by Levine. Another shot. Did it go in? No! Oh, my goodness! The Spartans with three golden opportunities, and somehow the Wolverines kept it out of the goal. That shot goes off the net.
You could not draw it up any better for a face-off win. Joe Ciccone's going to play a little goal in front of Hayden Levine as well.
Ooh.
And we're in behind him. Here's the difference in this game right now. Joe Ciccone's goal mouth defense in behind Hayden Levine.
No goal on the review. Wolverines pinch in now. Spartans carry out center ice. Kodorenko to Hirose. He'll dump in. Lefferman's off. 6-on-5 hockey right now. Spartans down a goal. Last minute of play in the third period. Miller. Kiefer. Gap to Miller. Lost it off a skate. And the Spartans will have to back up and reset. Final 50 seconds. Gatt wraps it around. Levine stops it behind his own net. Hirose has it. Centering pass, no. Kiefer is there. Puck is loose. Miller pinches in, but Hughes gets it ahead. Becker. His shot deep, but wide. 30 seconds to go. Hirose has a goal in this game. Long shot. Blocked by Levine. Kodorenko keeps it in.
He was hoping Levine would catch it for a faceoff.
Hughes has it. And he's going to eat up some of this time as he just softly dumps it into the Spartan zone.